Spontaneous is y over x, and the other one is x over y. So we'll just go with one of those two ways, and that'll make our proof half as long. So the way we will go is the x to the n, so that's the first case. Scroll way up, x to the n, so u is y over x. So we're only show for u equals y over x. And then, so we have the first case, so our two functions p of x, y could be rewritten as x to the n, and we'll go g1 of u and q of x, y equals x to the n g2 of u. So our two coefficient functions, where they are, right, the one in front of dx and the one in front of dy, we're just going to rewrite them in their homogeneous form. So we made our substitution, u equals y over x. We could rewrite this as x u equals y. And we're going to have to obviously substitute out the show. So our original ODE that we wrote down, we had that dx first plus q y dy equals 0. So we're going to substitute out pxy with x to the n g1u. So that takes care of that p function, q function. And I might need a little more space. So not only do I have to take out p of xy, I also have to change, let's see. We are letting y equal xu. So good news is dx stays the same. Q is x to the n g2 of u. The problem is because we changed y into ux, that's going to also change dy. So there's basically no more y's anymore. This is what we just did. So that means dy can't exist. So let's look and see what dy actually becomes. So right side is easy, dy. When I take derivative of both sides. What is derivative of the left side? Apparently, OneNote just updated to some new version that had that little math feature, and it's flashing a lot.
Is it going to be a product rule between the two?
Product rule. Anybody want to take a guess? So we'll get dx times u plus x times du. And let's write in nicer order. I'm going to put the u in front of the dx in that first term. I'm just going to reorder the first term. So it's u dx. So like a lot of proofs in this class, things will get way worse before they get better. So according to the theorem, this is separable. What does separable mean?
You can get all the u's with the du and all the x's with the x's.
Able to be separated, except we have x's and u's now. So we got to get x's together and u's together. We got no y's anymore, so let's get x's together and u's together. So u is y over x. So we made the assumption that p and q, somewhere up here, I didn't write the supposition down, but in our theorem.
That you were able to replace all of the ones in that the equation with the regular U's, and the only ones that had to use the F2 was Y, like outside of the.
Yeah, so what I didn't write down is suppose P and Q are homogeneous. Then I can do everything that's below. So I can make that homogeneous substitution. All right, so we will put all the x's together, all the u's together, and we'll do this very carefully. So no matter what, I have to distribute like that, because I got mixed x's and u's. The first term's fine, it's all x's. Well, it's almost fine, except the g1 of u. So we have x to the n, g2 u times another u, dx plus x times x is x to the n plus 1